Hello, Meteor.
Hello, Meteor.
Have you heard about the website called Discovery.com?
Discovery.com is my guidebook for life. I learned how to plant an herb garden, train my dog, and cure my dandruff.
I learned that most meteors burn up in Earth's atmosphere.
Hello everybody, welcome to my channel, and you'll notice that I never asked to hit the subscribe button, the bell button, or the thumbs up button, because I know that is entirely up to you, and you don't need to be hearing me asking all the time for you to do so. So with that out of the way, I purchased a record breaker length great white shark's tooth, and it's a replica, of course. Only can get a replica. And so it just came in today, and I am going to cut it open and let all my watchers of my channel see, as well as myself, see what we got in the package. So again, thank you for visiting my channel as always. Maybe I don't need to start. So I guess I gotta cut it. I can't. Yeah. Stuck on my finger. All right, here we go. Get some more light over here. The old bubble wrap. And that is nice. Not bad. And that is a big one. Yeah. That all out of the way. I'll be right back. I'm going to get my other great white shark tooth that is not a record holder in length and compare it to this one. So, let's see what we got going on here for... Ooh, yeah, that's a big difference. So, that's apparently a full-grown great white. And that's a record holder. A copy from a fossil. So, yeah, that's quite a bit of difference. That's a big boy there. Both replicas. Yeah. That is definitely a big boy compared to this one. Great white shark's teeth. Yep.
Many have asked me why I purchased a replica record size fossil great white shark's tooth. My answer is that these teeth from the United States are extremely rare, in Miocene and Pliocene layers, let alone any left available, that were by extreme chance found to sell for myself to be able to purchase. Why are these types of teeth so extremely rare? During the reign of Otodus megalodon, the largest shark to ever exist, the great white shark, Carcharodon carcharus, was at the same time keeping a low profile, and for good reason. Megalodon was much larger with a worse attitude, being the biggest and baddest boy on the block then, It isn't until the Pleistocene that fossil sharks' teeth of the great white shark are found with greater regularity, based on Megalodon being already extinct when the Pleistocene finally occurred. This illustrates that the great white shark was filling up the vacuum, the niche, that Megalodon ruled prior. Thus, the great white shark being able to grow record sizes compared to today's great whites. The size differences from the great white shark of then to today is possibly due to the massive environmental impact humans have had on the great white as the centuries with humans in the equation have gone by, such as pollution and hunting. Feeding damage on record-sized fossil great white shark's teeth indicates that even after the shark bit down on its prey, the tooth remained in its jaws for countless meals thereafter, just like megalodon teeth. The roots on record-sized fossil great white shark's teeth are extremely robust. No doubt the bite force of a great white shark this size would have required a robust root to anchor the teeth firmly in the jaws. Owning such a huge and real fossil great white shark tooth represents one of those rare life chances to add a record-sized prehistoric great white tooth to your collection. On the market, this type of fossil great white shark's tooth is becoming rarer and rarer to find, even in nice and complete condition, obviously making them more and more expensive to purchase as well. Thank you all for watching.